solo a
questa
slash
through. Through.
Well, this is such a high production definition of things
with a different editor, as you can read.
Production. That was a necessity. That kind of necessity is you need to set it always.
And I think we've already heard about the importance of all language. The importance of people being able to do this together.
And then,
when we became independent, the government realized that with the number of cultural groups in South Africa, there was a need to find a way of being able to do this together.
Can I realize that the subject of the existence of a magnificent of
Now, we note that, as I indicated, the government introduced the policy of reconciliation. And it was a reconciliation was meant to prevent peace and enable people to survive. And then, reconciliation can be defined as an overactive process which includes the search for truth, justice, forgiveness, healing, and so on. It means finding a way to live alongside former enemies, to coexist with them, to develop the degree of cooperation necessary to share our family with them so that we all have better lives together than we've had separately. That is from Rosie. And closely related to the above definition is what Mondo says, that is the position that
reconciliation is a process that establishes
love in understanding between two or more estranged parties.
Amongst Africans themselves. There was a neglect of relations
among the different parties that belong to the African communities in Zimbabwe. And then in the result, some people feel marginalized. And then the result was the civil war, which represents the characterized as the ethnic communities. So what I'm saying, the purpose of the protocol did not address the success. Because also the reason that I have communicated. But I was also saying, now we have no more control of society. What we need to do is to promote the process of mass culturalism through mass cultural education. And how do we do that? Mass cultural education is various aspects. I will look at the four aspects that I will look at and I realize that we have created the mass cultural education. The four are cognitive integration, knowledge consumption, prejudice reduction, inequity pedagogy, empowering school local children and civil structure. I'm not going to finish, I want to see you read those two. Then you use your materials like this, your various contact stories, and then you use from the diverse cultures, the ethnicities, and the identities in the curriculum. In other words, all the cultures of the country need to be represented within the school setting, within the classroom setting. And as you see, we have a whole division, we look at different attitudes towards other people. So we take the coding, their stories, what do the sun, what are the sun stories, how do we understand them? Shona stories, how do we understand them? The various stories, how do we understand them? How do they enrich the learning experience? The cognitive integration, in the language arts, in social studies, a more prominent role to play an element science. Indeed, the scientists here highlight scientists who were from marginalized groups, but that is not enough. And that was what I said, the aspect of funding would not be enough to promote monoculturalism in society again. So we need to do knowledge construction. What do we mean when we look at knowledge construction? And that the challenge of the learners to understand, investigate, determine the implicit knowledge of assumptions in front of reference and the perspectives of the discipline and attitude. The focus is on where we can understand and then construct knowledge. And the question and the differences are what are the values that underlie knowledge? How do historians, scientists construct knowledge? In other ways, how is knowledge constructed? So the teacher in the classroom works with the learners to construct knowledge. So that they are aware that knowledge is not something fixed, knowledge is socially constructed. And then they take advantage of that process of constructing knowledge. Because there are products of different cultures that are bringing different views of culture, different views of what is valuable, different views of what is important. And it just needs to be engaged in this. So that when they engage those, the students are aware that every culture is different from the other. And every culture allows what is different from what is valuable in the other culture. Then they get to the question. Just change the parameters about peace from the very special groups. And then both the others achieve. In other words, the teachers here to look at their classrooms and then they try to create conditions in such a way that all learners are able to learn. So they must be able to get something from the learning experience. And we said that the teachers need them to adapt their methods to understand the different learning styles within their classroom setting. The last one is the empowering culture and social structure, which is the allocation of the school culture, the structures, and all members of color, with the intention of restructuring institutional practices to create access for all groups. Then I'm going to explain who I think we were. This philosophy has been explained from the very beginning. And I think we're all interested in the idea of what it is. But perhaps just to say to be human is to understand the humanity and recognizing the humanity of others. It's infinity, highlight of modern and cost. Because the world and the world moves alive. Well, I remember the teacher says, I am because we are, since we are, therefore, I am. That's the summer. And then you can say, if you look at the values, well, and I think I will go through the If we go through the values that are promoted in Ubuntu, and if also through the values that are promoted in multiculturalism, these are non-nostical. We are not going to be able to achieve what we want. Without education, I don't think it will succeed. There is need for education. Why? In most cases, the older people, you and me, we tend to be very conservative. We don't normally accept new ideas. For us to accept new ideas to take root in society, pass the through education. Young ones are very receptive. They want to come and say what it is that they have not been the length of the situation. So that is why. We are saying there's a need for the inclusion of multicultural education, and we want to integrate sexual interests in the education of the more just to the human society. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Manyangu. And I remember my late dad saying, I remember, but now things have changed. We are living in the year. And now, so I want to focus on now. Thank you very much for the presentation. Now we invite Dr. Raymond to give us his speech.
How many people know what E equals MC squared means? Yeah, because you see, this is another cultural thing. We think of Einstein as genius because our culture says he is, not because we checked personally. Okay, myth three. There is no objective truth, only different cultural perspectives. Okay, I believe that there is in fact an objective truth. I don't believe that we can reduce truth to culture. If it were that simple, we could just create a culture where the concept of hunger doesn't exist, and then the Ethiopians stop starving. But unfortunately, objective truth still exists. And then myth four comes from myth three. It's the myth, no belief from one culture can ever be binding on another culture. And this goes hand in hand. If you believe there's no absolute truth, then you will not think that other cultures have anything to say to you or vice versa. But I believe if there's an objective truth, we shouldn't ask, well, is it from the West or is it from Africa? You should seek truth wherever it's about to be found, even if it's in the West in the year 1940, or wherever it comes from. It doesn't follow that the West has a monopoly on truth, but it doesn't follow Africa does either. Okay, myth five. My culture is perfect. And this myth, I don't mean specifically my, but whoever says this, whatever culture he belongs to, is believing in a myth. My culture is perfect. Now, there is a bit of a pervasive confusion between the concepts of understanding and comprehension. Because people sometimes say, well, maybe the West doesn't know everything, but it doesn't follow that the West knows nothing. Some people say, well, because nobody knows the whole truth, therefore nobody knows any truth. But that's mixing up the concepts of understanding and comprehension. Now, to illustrate what it is, do we understand what a grain of sand is? Well, I think we do, we know, but we can't eat it, it's not going to hurt us, and so on. But in order to comprehend the grain of sand, you'd have to be able to tell me, well, how many atoms does it have? How many years old is it during the Cretaceous period? What exactly was happening to this grain of sand? Where exactly was it before I picked it up? Etc., etc. That's just the scientific side. Philosophically, what is the essence of the grain of sand? And so on. Who created the grain of sand and why? And so I believe that actually, in order to comprehend the grain of sand, we have to know an infinite number of facts. So I don't claim that I comprehend a grain of sand. And if that's so, I also cannot comprehend a culture. I can't comprehend myself or God or the world. At most I can understand a bit of it. Okay, well, I'm Catholic, so that doesn't mean I don't believe in papal infallibility. Okay, but my view is that the Church doesn't know 100% of reality. It knows 1%, but it's infallibly certain about the 1%. So, you can know something without knowing everything and vice versa. Okay, so myth six. No culture superior to another in any area. Now, obviously, people with the legacy of racism, they don't like people claiming that their culture is superior. And I don't believe in cultural supremacism, which says that one culture is superior in all areas. But I think in order to dialogue, well, somebody has to learn from somebody. And if you have anything to learn from me, then I'm your superior. If I have something to learn from you, you're my superior in that area. So I'm superior to people in Latin, others are superior to me in Shona. So in order to learn from somebody, you have to we have to acknowledge the superiority in some area. Seven. The insiders to the culture are in a better position to judge it than outsiders in all areas. The problem with this is that the insider does not know the whole of his culture. If the insider always knew everything, then no British child would ever fail a course in Shakespeare. No African would ever fail a course in African languages department. But in fact, you should be humble enough to be told something about your culture. Not everything about your culture, but something about your culture from those who are looking at it on the outside and see what they can see. Now, myth 8. The default state of culture is one of separation from other cultures. Cultures should develop separately. Okay, trigger warning here, my views here, if they don't offend you, you probably haven't understood me. So, under the influence of colonialism, people are speaking of decolonizing the mind. I think I heard proposed, if I remember correctly, the suburb of Mount Pleasant in Harare should be renamed, and so on. So the question is, should Africa be Africa, West be the West, and there should not be any interchange? Africans should not have Western clothing, Westerners should not have African anything. Is that the ideal? Well, the ideal of separate development has in fact been tried in history. It was proposed by a person called Malan in South Africa, and it goes by the name of apartheid. It's interesting that if I say I believe that Africa and the West should develop totally separately and I call this apartheid, people say I'm wrong. But if I say, well, I believe Africa and the West should develop separately, and this is called decolonization of the mind, but if decolonization of the mind means you think independently and critically, you don't just accept Western ideas without questioning, that's fine. But if there's total separation between Africa and the West, then that to me is apartheid with a black face, or a white face, or whoever is proposing it. Now, myth 9, trigger warning again. Opinions here are not politically correct. Cultures are or should be the intellectual monopoly of their possessors. Those who use or borrow elements from a culture in ways not authorized by such possessors always act inadmissibly. So this idea of cultural appropriation, it arises when people object to people in Halloween costumes wearing Chinese disguise, if they're not Chinese. Or people object when there's a white person who plays an Asian actor. Okay, the idea is that culture is viewed as intellectual property, so Westerners may not use non-Western culture without permission. There's some people who want this to be understood as formal intellectual property, while others just say if you use other persons' cultural elements, it could be offensive to the cultures involved. Yeah, and I agree, you should try not to be offensive, but at the same time, I don't think it is necessarily a crime for you to use the elements of another person's culture without permission. Well, I'm a classicist, and I've never had the permission of any ancient Greek or ancient Roman to use their culture. And also, there are areas where non-Westerners have actually used Western culture without permission. So for instance, Rasta English. No one told the Rastas that you have permission to speak English this way, they just spoke it that way. And there's another example, this time from non-African culture, and if you'll allow me to wait, I've got a visual aid. Can anyone tell me what does this character mean?
When the colonial process was finished and the enemy was removed, we
very much. There's more, I'm sure.
Thank you very much.
I'll try to be. Let's try to be very brief because we're behind time.
I'll not be brief, I'll be very fast.
So I was thinking maybe if we go back to Ubuntu, my case, then we are able to have amicable relations, even outside considering what we call globalization.
Thank you, Bob. You have something in any response?
Well, apparently it was a comment more than it was a question.
It was a comment. It's a letter.
Well, your presentation was a policy or just a commandment or
a speech.
I would like to refer my brother to the words of Maono, Niwao, and Machakanja. Discover for yourself whether it was a policy or just a speech at a rally. But the fact that no structures were put in place to promote the policy does not mean it wasn't there. It was a policy, but there were shortcomings in terms of implementation of the policy.
Thank you very much, Bo. Unfortunately, we cannot go for a second round because we're running behind time and we need to go to our power sessions. Director Serum.
Thank you so much.